So they'll be up here. We'll get started right away with Sierra Street.
Good afternoon. Sorry to disturb your lunch, but I'm happy to be here. Thank you, Mr. Ford, for inviting me.
Thank you.
My name is Sierra Thomas Street, and I'm running for Judge of Court of Common Pleas. The election's coming up on November 5th, so we have about 3 weeks to go. So we're campaigning hard, trying to introduce ourselves to voters who haven't looked at us, at least that's what I'm doing, to make sure the voters are informed personally about the candidates. There are a lot of groups endorsing or not endorsing people, and endorsements are great. I recommend a few myself. But I think that the most important thing is for the voter to be personally aware of the candidates, and you make your own choice. That's what I suggest, and that's why I try to introduce myself to as many voters as possible. And unfortunately, in this type of election, we have a very low turnout, and I think it's because the voters don't really know the candidates. There's not a lot of TV commercials. There are no TV commercials, really, for judicial candidates. Not a lot of money flowing around. It's not like a mayoral or presidential election where you're constantly invested with images. You just don't know who these people are. And there are a lot of people running. There were 25 people, now there's 7. That's still a good number, and you probably don't know who they are. I'm one of them. Mr. Giovanni Campbell's another of the 7 who are running on the Democratic ticket. So a little bit about myself. I'm a former public defender, so I worked in court day after day, handling hundreds of cases, and got a feel for what it takes to be a judge. You need to know the law, and you need to have compassion for the people who come before you. Not every judge actually meets those standards. Those are my standards for a judge. Not every judge is able to do that. I think that's what allows for a fair trial, when a judge knows the law, but also understands a little bit about the community that comes before them. People can't put a wool over their eyes, and they won't lean towards one side always, which is what many judges do. I also think this year is an important election year for voters to get fired up, really, to go out and exercise their right to vote, because we have the Supreme Court coming down with rulings that are rescinding the Voting Rights Act. We need to show that we understand that our right to vote is important, and we're not going to lay down and not exercise it, especially in elections where we're expected not to come out. So make sure that you tell your family and friends about the election coming up November 5th. It's very easy to miss. And sometimes it's by design, I hate to say, because it's easy for people to put who they want in when people aren't aware that there's an election going on. So certain people vote and certain people are elected. I'm running on a Democratic ticket right now, and I'm pushing a Democratic ticket. But that's not how I got here. I got here through hard work, through like a kind of grassroots campaign that I ran against the odds. And I'm still working hard, and I'm gonna work hard when I get there, with your help. My button number is 207. As I said, I am pushing the Democratic ticket, especially Giovanni. But my number is 207, and I'm gonna pass out some literature to you today so that you remember me. I also worked in family court. I worked in the White House when I was in law school. And I am also a mother. I have 2 children, a 14-year-old son and a 10-year-old daughter. And I'm a divorcee, been through a marriage and divorce. So I understand the struggles of family and how that can hurt the family. And so that's important, because a lot of people end up in court over that, and it ruins their lives. And I'm not someone who believes in incarceration as the answer to everything. And I've also done a lot of work with Project Home, trying to inform people who have records, people who are incarcerated, about their voting rights, because a lot of people don't even know that you can vote if you're a convicted felon. A lot of people don't even know that you can vote while you're in jail if you haven't been convicted yet, if you're waiting to trial. And I actually was involved with the effort to have a political forum when it was Mayor Nutter's first term. He was running. And he actually was the only candidate who showed up, and he ended up winning. He came to the forum at Riverside Correctional Facility, which is the women's prison up on State Road. And we had a political forum right there in the prison. And so I used to go in and register people to vote who were incarcerated. You know, we had the absentee ballots, and so that they could vote even while they were in jail. People don't realize that Pennsylvania, with all of its flaws, that's that's the one great thing that they do have, that law that allows convicted felons to also participate. There are other states in this country that don't allow that. And that's a shame, because how can you take someone's right to vote? I mean, after they've done their time and they're supposed to be rehabilitated back into society, and then they still don't have the rights that everybody else does? You can't really explain that. That's the law in many states, not this one. And a lot of people don't realize that. That's one good thing about living here in this state, and one good thing that we need to expand upon. So, thank you for having me. November 5th, button number 207. I am pushing the Democratic ticket too. And my name is Sierra Thomas Street.
All right, so if you can have your questions ready, we'll let the other candidate come up and speak, and we'll ask them both the questions that you may have all at one time. So we'll hear the full presentation. So, Giovanni Kennedy.
Thank you very much. My name is Giovanni Campbell. I'm also running for Philadelphia Board of Common Pleas. And the reason I'm running is because I have the integrity, the experience, the history of public service, and the right judicial temperament to be an asset to the bench. I've been practicing for nearly 20 years, and I've been actively involved in litigation that entire time. My practice is criminal defense, trial, and appellate work, and some civil rights litigation, mostly in federal court. And as a result, I've appeared before judges literally thousands of times, and I've been involved in numerous jury trials, both in federal and state court. In my early career, I was involved in other types of law, like contracts law and personal injury and things like that. And I say these things to tell you that that I have more than ample experience. It's extensive and varied, and that's important because you want a judge who's making some important decisions about the law to really understand the law, just the way you would want a referee in a boxing match or a tennis match to know the rules of the game. But just as important as that experience is the recognition that behind every decision, there's a person being affected. And I've always recognized that because I was brought up with a very strong sense of fairness, and I was taught to treat people the way I like to be treated. And those are the values that have motivated me to do certain things with my career. For example, I practiced from neighborhood locations in North Philadelphia, Fishtown, and Kensington most of my career in order to make the legal process a little more accessible to disenfranchised communities. I've also provided pro bono representation my entire career, both in civil and criminal matters, not only independently, but also in partnership with public interest agencies like the public interest agencies like the Volunteers for the Indigent Program and the Public Interest Law Center of Philadelphia as examples. I also very strongly believe in teaching young people about the law because it helps them to understand that they are a relevant part of society. And that's the best deterrent that there is. And I've been involved in that since law school through various programs, various mock-trial programs hosted by Dresville University, LaSalle University, Temple University, and also programs like the Advancing Civics Education Program through the Philadelphia Bar Association, through which we actually teach directly about the law in Philadelphia high schools. And as far as the judicial temperament, I really believe in treating people the way I like to be treated. And it's not always easy to be civil, because you can imagine that in many trials and litigation situations, things get very contentious. But I think it's not only right, but it's also practical. The fair administration of justice is something that's a lot more likely to happen when there is civility in the courtroom. And everyone looks to the judge for the cues on how to act and how to treat people. And that's another thing that I can bring to the bench. And last but not least, for those of you who hear an accent, I'm originally from Panama. I came here when I was 12 years old, so I'm an immigrant. And I also bring that global perspective to the bench that's well suited to a city of the first class like Philadelphia. And I hope for your support. Hope that you vote for myself and also Sierra Street. My number is, where's my number? So then don't make me 209, I think you're 205.
I'm
207. Okay. Well, fortunately, there's only 7 names on the ballot now. Go by the name, not the number. I'm going to hand these out. Right? Giovanni Campbell like the soup. And that's about it. Open to any questions.
candidates want to remain up front, we'll just pass the mic and we'll freestyle, allow folks to ask their questions.